So guys, by now you might have already known a lot of operators, a lot of details about Oracle SQL. Now, let us understand something called as ampersand substitution. So what is this ampersand substitution? Understand, you are running a query. We assume that you want to get some data for respective employees, right? So in this case, you are running a query again and again inside the database. So what happens is it becomes very hard to construct your queries beforehand and then run them against the database. I know it's confusing, so let us look at this in a simple way. So I would say ampersand substitution. So what is this ampersand substitution? Let us assume your manager gave you a task where he said that, okay, get me separate outputs or separate reports for the employee table where the name starts with A, B, C, D, E, and so on. So what you will do is, in this case, you will first write a query, select star from HR dot employees where first name like, and it starts with A, so A percent. Perfect. So this is how you will write the query, and you will execute this query inside the database. And let us run this one. Okay, first name like, I think we'll have to give single quotes, right? So let us run this one. Perfect. So now we have the output where the first name starts with A. All right. Understand, in this example, your manager asked you to take the output, I mean separate output for employee names starting from A to Z. Now, can you imagine how tedious it becomes, like writing these queries like this and then execute all the queries against the database? So what we will have to do is we'll have to write how many, 26 such statements, and then execute it against the database. It becomes very tedious, right? The same goes with multiple departments. Let's take your manager said, hey, select all the employees from HR dot employees where department underscore ID is equal to 10. Now, if you have 200 departments, then what you will do? You'll have to write queries like this and then execute all the queries against the database. Now, this becomes a tedious job, and because of this, you have an option to substitute the where condition or any value inside a query at the runtime. Now, how does it work? For example, in this case, what we do is we use an ampersand variable, ampersand first name and ampersand department ID. So how does it work? So your queries will change something like this. Select star from HR dot employees where first name like, and within the quotes you will give this ampersand variable. So after ampersand, what exactly is ampersand? Ampersand is nothing but it's the name of this symbol. That's the and symbol, right? So this ampersand, and then you can give whatever the name that you want to give. It's just for your understanding, and then you can run the query. Now, whenever you run this query again and again, only one query you will have to run. Whenever you run this query, the SQL will ask you what is the value of this ampersand variable. Now, at the runtime, you can say that it is A percent, B percent, C percent, D percent. And likewise, you don't have to write so many queries. You can substitute the values using the ampersand variable. So let us run this query and see how it works. I'm not sure if in SQL Developer we can use the ampersand substitution. Okay, it works. Now, can you see it's asking us to enter the value of first name? So from where it got this first name? It's nothing but after ampersand, whatever you put, that's the same thing it will ask you. Okay, so always it's good if you put meaningful name over there. So I'll give you some students, they'll also use something like this value. Now when they run this kind of query, they forget what value they have to input, because your SQL developer will say like enter value for value. Now that confuses the students. So this is the reason whenever you are using ampersand variables, make sure you are always following the naming conventions. So the best thumb rule is whatever the value is, if it is for a particular column, give the column name as the ampersand variable name. So now in this case, I want to query a percent. So just type the value that should replace this ampersand variable. So in our query, this is the value it must replace the first name, right? So that's why I'm only typing a percent. These single quotes, they are already available in the query. So don't try to type those single quotes. Okay, now click on OK. Perfect. Now what do you see? We see that all the records where the first name starts with A. Perfect. Now you copy the output, then rerun the query and then give it B percent, click on OK. Now we got all the employees with the first name starting with B, take the output and then run the query again, then give C percent, click on OK. And then now you will get all the employees whose name starts with C. Now can you imagine, rather than writing so many queries, what you can do is you can use the ampersand variables. So these ampersand variables help you simplify your job when you are working on similar type of queries on a repetitive basis.